Love God, hate sin.
What makes you laugh, Isaiah?
Stinky feet.
Like yours?
Yes, sir.
Do stinky feet make you laugh? Faith. Oh, really? Do you like laughing?
Yes, sir.
It's fun to laugh because it shows that you're happy.
My funny thing I've ever laughed at is you talking to a silly and birthdays.
Birthdays?
One is when people chase me around and they're about to tickle me. And another thing is when you make funny faces like this.
What makes you laugh? Food? What about you? What makes you laugh?
Faith's butt.
Oh, when Faith fell on her back? That was funny. Did she cry? That's not funny. What about you?
Modern society today can be pretty discouraging. Men are judged by their physique, their physical form. Men are judged by their looks. Men are judged by their money, their possessions, their success, their job. But when it comes to the Word of God, really one
good,
thing
y'all.
Defines
that's
man.
Your brother, Tawfiq Cotman-El, and it's time for Manhood Mondays. And we're going to be talking about today laughter. All right, y'all, so it's a little different today. We're just going to be talking about something real lighthearted, pun intended. We're going to be talking about laughter. Why? Well, as men, there's so much that we take seriously. We're the leaders of our home, leadership in the church, leadership on the job, leadership in the world, taking charge, protecting. There's so much to be serious about. We know that this world is filled with seriousness. In our next Manhood Monday, we're going to be talking about being sober-minded. But today, we're going to be talking about laughter, because sometimes we can be so serious that we lose sight of something that the scripture tells us is good for us. So here we got Proverbs 15:13, and it says this: a glad heart makes a cheerful face. You know, it's kind of like what the scripture says, from the abundance of the heart the mouth speaks. Here we see a glad heart makes a cheerful face. What's going on inside the heart should reflect on what's in the face. So, if in my heart I'm glad, and what are some things for our hearts to be glad about? How about the fact that if you're a believer, no wrath. Is that something to smile about? Absolutely. How about this? Forgiveness for all of your sins, past, present, and future. You think you can smile about that? Absolutely. How about this? The power to be done with your sin. That sin that has so easily entangled you, it says put it away. Cast aside every weight. We have the power by the Spirit of God to do this. You think that's worth smiling about? You better believe that it is. Well, how about this one? The promise that He will always be with us. Never leave us, never forsake us. Will this in your heart make it glad? And if it does, then shouldn't it show on our faces? Absolutely. Now, I know that I'm one who doesn't smile quite as much as I could. So this is a gut check to me, as I pray that it will be to you, some conviction. Listen, we have a great salvation. We have no wrath to face. We have the forgiveness of all of our sins. We have the power of God to put sin away. We have Christ with us here, and more importantly, we will be with Christ forever and all of eternity. We will spend eternity in joy and bliss and pleasure and fellowship and loving our King, loving our God, being amongst the brethren, the saints. We will have our prayer turned to praise, our faith realized. We'll have all these things present. He'll wipe away every tear. There'll be no more crying, no more sighing, no more pain, no more grief, only joy and eternal love. That's something to smile about. And it's important. Those of us who have wives, listen, those of us who have children, listen, those of us who don't, if you're just living and people know that you're a Christian, shouldn't there be some type of joy in our souls, joy in our heart that is showing up on our face? Like I said, next Manhood Monday, we're going to be talking about being sober-minded, because some people take this way too far and everything is silly. But the fact that you can laugh, the fact that you can have a smile on your face, the fact that you can stop and play with some children, it's good to laugh, it's good to smile, it's good to have a cheerful face. Why? Because of what's going on inside your heart. Now, a lot of people, they only notice because of what's going on inside the heart, the face is glad. Some people will only be glad because of what's going on inside the world. And if what's going on inside the world, what's going on out here, isn't cheerful, then the face won't be cheerful. We don't want to be that way. Those are the people who are moved by happy. You know, there's a song, Happy, and everyone's all excited about this big happy thing. Well, happy really has more to do with what's happening, doesn't it? But we're talking about joy. And the joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy that's within my heart shows up on my face. And I have a smile on my face because I know no matter what happens to me, I'm going to be with Christ. No matter what happens to me, I have my sins forgiven. No matter what happens to me, no matter how bad my life is, I'm not going to face eternal destruction and damnation. I won't be separated from the lover of my soul. And the fact that I know that no matter where I go, no matter who I'm with or what happens to me, Christ is with me. I'm his sheep. He is my shepherd. The Father is mine. The Son is mine. The Spirit is mine. The Word is mine. The promises of God are mine. Yes, forgiveness of sin is mine. Power over sin is mine. I have eternal life and it's mine. These are all gifts given by faith to those who believe. You tell me that's something that you can't smile about? Brother, sister, I know it's Manhood Monday, but some of the sisters watch. Smile. Show the world that we have something to smile about. They laugh at all kinds of foolishness. They laugh at things they shouldn't laugh at. They laugh at things that make God very angry. I mean, you shouldn't laugh at that. But the things that we should smile about, there's true, pure humor. There's good things in this world that should bring a smile to our face. God is the one that gave us the muscles to smile. He's the one that gave us a sense of humor. He's the one that made us do something called laugh, and it's good for us. Listen to this one. Proverbs 17:22. A joyful heart is good medicine. It's medicine. Sick. But listen to this. But a crushed spirit dries up the bones. And that's your alternative. You got a crushed spirit or you got a joyful heart. Joyful heart, crushed spirit. Joyful heart. What would send my heart full of joy? See? Full of joy. Joyful. Not happy. 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 Not happy. Joyful. That's what we want to be as Christians. We want to be joyful. Full of joy. And what would make my heart full of joy? Christ. What would make my heart full of joy? The promises of God that find their yes and amen in Christ. What would crush my spirit? Well, if you don't have Christ, there's nothing for you to smile about. If you don't have the promises of God, there's nothing for you to be full of joy about. And everything in your world is dependent on what happens out here, because inside you're dead men's bones. Inside you're lost and you're damned and you're doomed, and there's nothing inside of you worth smiling about. And if you're there, you're headed for destruction. But be of good cheer, because Christ is willing and able to save you. Everything is ready. The feast is prepared. The banquet is prepared. The invitation has been offered. Come to the wedding. Come to the feast. Come to the banquet. Come to Christ in faith. Don't bring any money trying to pay your way. He won't accept it, and he won't accept you. But if you come empty-handed, only bringing your weakness, only bringing your need, only bringing your sin to be saved and paid for, then he'll take you. And you don't try to hold on to it, but you surrender that thing, emptying yourself of any effort, any righteousness, any help, any ability, emptying yourself of everything. And all you have is your weakness and your need and your dependency. And you come with faith and he'll save you. And then your heart will be full of joy. And you too can have a cheerful countenance. Be of good cheer. Christ has overcome the world. So, brothers, men, let's smile. Tickle your children. Laugh. Laugh with your wife. Laugh with your brothers and your sisters. Enjoy. Show that the heart that has been rescued, turned from a heart of stone to a heart of flesh, is full of joy, and let that show in your face. And I'm talking to myself, number one, first. Let's smile for the glory of God, brethren. Love y'all. Like I said, next week, Lord willing, we're going to be talking about being sober-minded. Sober-minded. Bible has much to say about it. So, until then, love God, hate sin. And by the grace of God and the Spirit of God, may we have strength to man up. Grace and peace. One. You hear me screaming, I'm so in need of you. I fight these thoughts like every evening. Of all I need to do, seeing how I lack and leading. Praying, reading to my family's counting on me, leaning. That they'll be seeing you and all I do, how I love. But I'm not confident, this narrow path is hard and rough. I need your providence, it's obvious I'm not enough. And yet you gave your boy your wife. When to die and let her win, when to stand alone and fight. I don't know, I'm clueless, I need you more than ever. My anger gets the best of me, pride becomes my treasure. You're holding me accountable, I need
need to treat her better. My kids are looking up to me to lead them towards forever. But after work, I feel like watching TV. This